Hello friends, my name is Behrouz and welcome to my channel where I share with you tips, tricks that I read, learn and apply in order to become my best version. Now in this video, I will help you answer one of the most commonly asked interview question, which is what are your salary expectations? Now I will try to address this question from two different angles. One is a very general or a standard way of responding to the question. That is, if you are asked this question on any normal or a standard day, how you should go about responding. And second is a response that is dependent on your state of affairs. What is your current situation? What are the current state of affairs with regards to your current job, the job you're looking for, how desperate you are, and so on and so forth. And basis that, your response may be slightly different than a very standard or a general response. Now, let me start with the easy one, that is the general or the standard response. Here, you need to begin with first understanding what is the industry that you're applying for and what are the job requirements. And then go online and search for what are the typical salaries in that industry and for those particular roles or the job requirements that which you are applying for. On the web, you will find a number of resources such as LinkedIn, Glassdoor, and many others where you can find salaries that you should expect to earn for a particular role in a particular industry. So much so that there are even salaries listed for particular roles in particular companies. For instance, if you're applying for Amazon as a sales manager, you can easily find the salary for a sales manager in Amazon on the web. Now, when it comes to answering the question, make sure that you provide a range. This will allow you some flexibility to negotiate once you've gone through the interview and you are in the hiring stage. For example, you can say something like this. Based on my research and understanding of the requirements that you have for the role or the job, my salary expectation is between X to Y, which is giving a range. However, I'm open to discussing the salary in more detail once I start going through the interview stages. So with this, you have kind of given an indication to the hiring personnel that you are open to discussing the salary or negotiating it once the right time comes. So much so that you can even choose to go higher than the range that you've quoted just because in the beginning, you left the room open for negotiation. So let's say if you had a range between X and Y, you can even go higher than that range that you previously had given, as I said, only because you kept the room open for negotiation since you said we can discuss it further once the right time comes. With that said, the negotiation can even go downwards because as per the hiring personnel, they only went through the process of interviewing because you said in the beginning that you were open to discuss and negotiate. Now comes the second part, which is more specific, which is more dependent on the particular situation that you have and the state of affairs. And here I see three situations in which a person can at any given point in time find themselves in. One, they're frustrated from their current job and they want to change and get hired in a different company at any cost. That is pure desperation to move out of their current role and job. Second is they are actively looking for another job. However, they are not keen on leaving their job today. Rather, they are looking for something better and something good and can spare some time by working still at the current place that they're working on, which means they're not very desperate. However, they're actively looking. And third is where you're not actively looking. You are happy with the state of affairs and the job that you have. And someone like a recruiter approaches you with a very good opportunity. And you're like, okay, let me consider and let me test the waters out there. And that would be this third kind of a situation that you may find yourself in when you are asked this question or when you are going into an interview. Now let's start with the first situation, which is you are desperate to get a job. Usually the situation is when you are fresh getting out of the college, you don't have any prior experience and you just want to get hired, or you've recently lost your job and you don't see any other prospect but to make sure that you get hired in this particular organization that you've applied for. And hence you don't want to screw up with giving any wrong answers to the question, which is what are your salary expectations. In that case, the best answer is to say that I expect to be paid competitively. That is at par with my peers and average income of this role in this particular industry. That is, in this way, you have informed the hiring personnel that you expect to be paid fairly and as per the industry standards. This also gives you a lot of room to haggle once the final salary amount is quoted to you. Since you did not share a number or a range prior to the starting of the interview process, hence you still have room to negotiate at any extent. This is even easier when you're applying for a big corporation because they have resources to benchmark salaries for the roles that they're applying for internally and externally. And hence they will make sure that the salary that they are offering or the range that they have internally designed for that particular role is fairly paid and is benchmarked correctly and comparatively versus the industry. And hence you should expect to be paid fairly in those companies, and therefore it is best to say that I expect to be paid competitively. Now let's talk about the second scenario, where you currently have a job, you're holding on to that job, but you're still actively looking for something better than what you currently have. In that case, you already have a benchmark with you, that is your current salary. Chances are you're looking for something which is slightly sweeter than what you're already getting paid for. Hence, in that case, it would be best to benchmark versus your current salary and ask for a salary that is sufficiently higher than what you're making today. And it is best to address this at the start of the hiring process, because there may be instances where you go through the entire hiring process only to realize that what you are being offered is at par or lower than what you're currently making. And hence, in that case, it doesn't make sense for you to leave the job in which you are currently comfortable. Now, in the third scenario, where you are comfortable and happy with the current job and the current organization that you're working for, however, you have been approached by an external recruiter. In that case, you will still go ahead and use your current salary as a benchmark. However, the delta on that salary needs to be significantly higher for you to make the move. As a rule of thumb, you should expect to be paid 50% more than what you're making today if you are to move from a job in which you are currently very much comfortable and happy. So in this case, you can simply apply a significant increment to your current salary, 50% or plus, and then after the end of the hiring process, you can still go ahead and haggle for anything extra, just because they were the ones who were desperate to hire you. They were the ones who were poaching you while you were comfortable in your role. But as a starter, you can always start and use your current base salary as the benchmark and ask for a significant increment on top of that. Hopefully this video was of help for you to now be able to answer this very strange and difficult question, which is, what are your salary expectations? Thank you.